Welcome everyone to this update. I spend a little bit too much time because also lesson learned, do not waste your time with automated build system stuff like T2 for the kernel, because even on a data center that compiles some 30 minutes and added compile round trip time of 30 minutes is not amazing. So what to do instead? Don't use this kind of T2 Gentoo, open build, whatever, but certainly T2 is the best. And so, where are my many here? Cool Vintage. So, what I mean with this is, so I suspended here the build in Tmux and edited manually around here. So this is of course reduces round trip time from 30 minutes to just a couple of minutes. And so even better, maybe I shouldn't. So what have I done? So first of all, we have booted that here. And that is the very latest and great, well, not the very latest and greatest. Actually, maybe I should have. Anyway, you get the idea. That is probably should be also wrong keyword. So also you probably want this larger, I guess. But this is only rough proof of concept, only to document here all the steps. And also, by the way, all of you could have done this. Don't need to always wait for me. This is also why we do the other educational stuff with the Voodoo and stuff. So, and as I said in the earlier live stream this morning that you probably want to watch again if you missed this, I knew this new kernels will not boot and just work like over 5.0 Linux kernel. So now we have here, because of chain, I hate Unicode, crap. So 5.0.15. 5.1 results in a black screen and 5.2 reboots. And some panic beep red light thing that has to be investigated next, unfortunately. This, I will not reiterate what I said this morning. This is exactly what I like, what I do not like with Linux kernel, all this ever-changing APIs. And what people on Phoronix praise, like, yeah, they changed something, but yeah, honestly, all this refactoring mostly not worth so much, in my opinion. What we have done also the first time, not sure if anyone else ever did this. Let's just increase here our camera. So you have seen here, or you may or may not have spotted this. This is an amazing black spot there. Do we have, we don't really have mouse here. So here is a black spot you see. It's normally, this is also not, wrong keyword, scrolling, okay. So you see even when we scroll text here, so there is some black triangle. And what this is finally the hardware cursor. What I mentioned already, so although this is a low hanging fruit, I always mentioned, yes, this is some small thing after here some hours of recompiling Linux kernel, but I'm still not completely done here. And what this hardware cursor allows us so far on Linux ever, so of course Sony official other OS was never hardware accelerated, and even with hardware acceleration the cursor was always software painted, which is of course wasting CPU cycles that are better spent for anything else. Besides, it's flickering because the area of the mouse cursor needs to be saved, and if the screen content or the mouse moves needs to be restored and repainted, and this certainly not only wastes CPU cycles, but also flickers annoyingly. And if we want to use this here daily to make this totally amazing again, eventually or something, for which you can share, like, and subscribe, then we want such amazing features. So I've hard coded this here right now, proof of concept, because I've never tried this before. I've seen this in the reverse engineering documentation here of other people, that we can also change the scene here. So you see this here on screen. I've simply brute force hard coded here some stuff. This is also no magic stuff. All of you could have tried this if you just have wanted and get the fame of being the first to do this stuff. So this is here on the PS Dev Wiki, PS3 hypervisor reverse engineering. So I've not reverse engineered this, not that Sony wants to sue me this. I only use here what is in the open of the internet. We are not doing here any black business. So this was documented already for a decade, I guess, by these amazing people who have done all this amazing reversing work. And so I saw this, so this is when I revived this last year, this spotted this, and so this would be amazing to eventually do. You see this is totally easy, LV1, which is a hypervisor GPU context attribute context, this is our context handle that we get from the hypervisor when we initialize the device. And here's some attributes. You see here also many other attributes like flip mode and display buffer and all this kind of fun stuff. So these are just some magic numbers, API numbers, similar to system calls, like read is 17 or whatever that might be on Linux and Windows, something else. So these are just some magic numbers that of course should be documented nicely with some symbol name. Of course, for now I've just hard-coded this for a quick test. So this is not different than P3FB. So there are already other magic numbers, oops, like maybe head, but maybe not. Yeah, you see some context. Why is here some context? Is it some parameter? Yeah, so there should already, although I'm actually surprised in the Linux kernel frame buffer that this is not like defined like head A and like 0 and 1. This should also not be magic values, by the way, doing here some on the fly code review. And this is official code from those people Sony employed for other OS back in the day. That is likely, we can check here some whatever. So the funny thing is we run this here in GameOS, but this is copyright Sony 2006-2017 from whoever did this. Anyway, so cursor. This is of course only proof of contact concept. Here are these numbers 0B for all of those for this kernel, for this cursor numbers, and B for cursor init position offset stuff. So this init is just initialized, I guess, doing some housekeeping. And then the offset is the offset in the frame buffer. So you have some 256 megabyte of GPU memory and you could place the cursor anyway. So anywhere. So at address zero, this is why we have done all the other videos for DOS, Voodoo, Verge, Rendition Verity and all the other fun stuff. So you see why do I do this, that you learn something and that you can do this stuff yourself and get famous and do GPU programming at NVIDIA, AMD and Sony and Microsoft and Linux kernel and stuff. So you need to place this stuff somewhere. So usually often the frame buffer starts at address zero. So this is where the visible picture is. And maybe you have double buffering, then you have this two times. And then maybe you start placing the cursor there or you start with the cursor from the end. It doesn't really matter. So anywhere. So this is most likely, I'm guessing here, but doesn't make any other logic sense. Offset in the frame buffer. All right, now zero just for the test because I thought we have there some pixels so that we should see something. We can check this in a second. XY position, I've just, oh, this is why, okay, I want to turn it 100, probably hit X or delete or something. Anyway, doesn't really matter. This explains why the cursor is so high, I was already wondering. And then there is some other attribute stuff that they have documented here with some question marks, so whatever that is doing. Maybe that is attribute, where is it, image offset, was it not here somewhere, whatever, doesn't even, I was also reading another site, maybe that was on the other side. So this is how it works, not too much different from low level hardware, bare metal, just that you do not write these values directly into the memory mapped IO, but ask the hypervisor nicely. This is actually like nearly identical, well not 100%, but conceptual identical to VMware or QEMU VirtIO graphics that we also want to take a look another day. So you see all of this is not so different and you could just do this help. So it would be highly appreciated if you're interested in this kind of fun stuff that maybe you also take a look into this stuff and send me some patches. It would be, and even if you do not test them, by the way, as I mentioned in this earlier live stream this morning, someone sent me a patch, it wasn't tested, it wasted a couple of hours because I thought it it works and it didn't, and I saw it's a problem somewhere else. So if you send me a patch that's not tested, that's fine as well. Just put there a huge disclaimer in line 0. Hello, this is not tested, just for work in progress, something. So what we do need to do next is, of course, this cannot be once in initialization. So the very nice thing would be to make some very modern kernel mode setting DRI driver that we will for sure not do this year, maybe another year or something of that sort. However, what we will do in the short term, because we like here quick and dirty hex solutions, actually really not, but for this P3 stuff we do until we figure out all those magic values. So what I will do next is add here some IOCTL, and add here a custom. You see we have here already vblank and other, we have here other custom stuff for our hacky video acceleration stuff, and I will just add here somewhere, wherever that was, another custom IOCTL for enable cursor, so that I can also modify the xDriver. You see how much work is all this stuff. Next I need to modify the xDriver to internally allocate the cursor and manage it nicely, and then have this IOCTL called, this IO control called into the kernel to call this here dynamically, and then instead of painting there all the window, we will call into the hypervisor and ask the hypervisor for each mouse movement to position the cursor. How this works internally, of course, the hypervisor, if you would disassemble the hypervisor, which of course I will not do or have not done or something of that sort, the hypervisor will of course then just write these values. This is most likely very identical to standard NVIDIA desktop hardware. So the hypervisor will just take these values and write them one-to-one into the NVIDIA whatever series. I think I documented this here, 6000, whatever that may have been. Did I not put it somewhere? Anyway, you get the idea. That is what's happening behind the scene. X server, xDriver, IOCTLs into the kernel. Kernel kind of IOCTL virtualization traps into the hypervisor. The hypervisor sets the registers. Sounds a little bit inefficient, but that is not different from VMware, QEMU and virtualization stuff, and certainly much faster than this flickering garbage of, at least I hope faster. Anyway, and last but not least, we certainly want, by the way, you need to stay another minute to get another work in progress hack. And don't forget to share, like, and subscribe if you want me to continue. Patreon also appreciated, because you see this takes so much time. Most time actually not the, I would love to focus on RSX hacking, but I'm already 99% less motivated if the Linux kernel people break the stuff for us. Last but not least, to check this, so we have this black rectangle that we with our totally amazing, where is even our so much zoomed in, are we already zoomed in so much to totally amazing. Then we need to ask Jack to position this, already fully zoomed in, so actually we can also actually change the view. Too much hacking today. So to test this, we can scroll here, so this should be address 0 where the cursor offset is. Again, later it will of course be off screen, so this is on screen. This is not how you normally do this. I only do this kind of stuff for debugging. On screen meaning it is on the scanout buffer, on the frame buffer that is scanned out by the DAC, the digital analog converter, and the digital DVI transceiver here, or HDMI transceiver in this case. And normally, you don't put the cursor here visibly. You need to put this off screen where it's not visible. But none the case for debugging. We can scroll this here a little bit, if also wrong keyboard, obviously. And then we see that if we arrange it so, maybe also piping this through less. This is how I actually kind of also prefer this debugging. So if we manage to have something, the problem is that this first line there is black with this font. This is why, but I had there already actually pre-tested this. Let's see, Yeah, you see, so now with this text highlighted there, you see that we get some lines in here. And so this most likely means we have here some black and white cursor, maybe, maybe not. Actually, we should, or do we have actually, if we would have here, not necessarily, it's actually a little bit large for a black and white cursor. Anyway, you get, no, actually, it's not a black and white cursor because it is way too large. Otherwise, if it would be one bit black and white, it would be much larger. I actually think it's probably an RGB cursor. Otherwise, it doesn't make much sense. Just that the stride, the bytes per pixel line, are of course, huge. And we just have here 64 or whatever pixels, something of that sort. Anyway, this details we need to figure out. Maybe that is also this other undocumented or not fully documented value. Was it here somewhere? Here was. I also had actually so much to closing this. I had another side also open. Maybe that is what this other API call is there. What maybe this or the other side had not documented here. This was with this question marks. There's also some four. So you see this API parameter 1, 2, 3, and 4, and they had their question marks. So maybe you can also set the attributes for the image bitmap format for black and white, one bit black and white with transparency versus RGB or some sort, or even cursor size like 32, 64 bit pixels, something of that sort we could put there. We could call there with random values and see if something changes another day. This is already amazing progress. Theoretically, this is just maybe one afternoon modifying the Xorg driver and the kernel driver. But what I have, I wanted to say, so it's not still not everything amazing and trouble-free, because the other problem is I've still not solved this with this stupid kernel API change. That is, of course, now you see so many PS3 disks, so many files touched today. So that is, are here our regions, that are these details are in the first live stream from today. We have multiple storage regions, and the kernel people changed the internal API. They actually, after changing this, introducing a new multi-queue API for higher performance that we don't really need, but whatever. And unfortunately, after a year or 2 or 3 years, they now have deleted the old API. So they actually had changed this for us, because this is still upstream in the regular vanilla kernel for theoretically still running on the good old other OS of official Sony fame, which of course probably nearly nobody has anymore. And they changed this, but we have 4 storage regions. So when we run in the official Sony stuff, we only have 1 storage region. And so we have 4 for all the game OS also, so we can mount and access game OS, which we don't really need so much. So the way I have worked around it is, because I could not yet get this to run. And if you are familiar with Linux kernel development, so this is something that you could help me and take a look in, that you see, usually this should be 0, region index 0 to num regions, which should be maximal 8 here right now in this reverse engineered stuff from other people from a decade ago. And I basically gave up after an hour or two on this, and I simply just use here the 4th region and don't care about the rest. What happened, so I merged this together and forward ported this, but it doesn't really work. So it is not crashing, but it's also not working. What I think is happening, so if we create here 4 regions, like the only thing that changes is this number. Instead of 3 to num regions, it's 0 to num regions, which is what it usually should be. Well, the problem is, I think previously this was always serialized. Now what happens is, with this multi-queue stuff, all of those queues apparently run in parallel, which maybe they somehow, due to sheer luck or maybe by design, I don't know, they didn't do before. And it is not crashing, but it's also not working when we get an interrupt. So here's the interrupt handler, which is also, again, educational content. You may or may not have seen this from the DOS stuff, from interrupts with Sound Blaster and timer and fun stuff like this. And what is happening is that we get this interrupt called and we share this interrupt. So this is one driver and one interrupt for any of those storage regions. And this was also before, this was working, this is okay. But the problem is that when we queue this to the hypervisor, there is here the queue submit here, this is PS3 disk submit flush request and scatter gather request. And those are here calling into the hypervisor LV1 storage send device command and with LV1 storage ATA HDD out. And it's probably storing here some reference tag value into this address of this dev pointer, our private driver structure, in some tag value. And before this worked, even before with this four storage regions in the good old code, this worked. However, now they apparently run more in parallel than they did before. Although each of those queues, not this queues, are actually created with a queue depth of one. And you see, why do I document this and queue init here, should merge here. This is a queue depth. I think this is a queue depth of one init block multi queue init whatever queue. And so this queue depth is actually one. So this means it should only queue one command at a time, which is not efficient and not amazing, but whatever. I'm not sure if we could actually improve on this. Maybe we could actually now with this new infrastructure, maybe. But so what is happening? Interrupt. So this, we have only one of those tag values and maybe I need to change this then to use multiple of these tag values because right now we have only one tag value. So when the Linux kernel, it sees four of those queues and they are all getting probed. And so it's like queuing some, I think, ATA identify command block, I guess. I've not debugged this in such detail. I only see there are commands I've not analyzed, which of those doesn't really matter for me. What matters is that it needs to work. It doesn't matter if it's an inquiry or read or whatever, anything of that sort. And the interrupt handler, this is not my code. This code is even, I think this is vanilla upstream kernel. So this is right now, if in any of your compiled kernels on in the official upstream kernel source, this is already there. And it's comparing the tag we get here. So we call here LV1 storage get asynchronous status here, which is this tag and status. And it's comparing here this tag to that is asynchronous status thing that is returned with this. We have only one. So also the problem is already because we get here multiple commands issued by the Linux kernel, we override this tag anyway. This is already not good, certainly. Because the first command is issued, maybe we get actually this tags are 0 and 1. Maybe they are just sequentially incremented. Maybe they would be 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and maybe eventually 1 million, I guess, maybe. And first of all, when the second command is issued to the hypervisor, we already clobber and override our tag. That is not good. And then when the second command gets handled faster, maybe because of whatever reason the hypervisor it's not getting handled faster. So we submit two commands and we override the second command, overrides the tag, and then the tag is 1, but it should be 0, and then we get this interrupt and the asynchronous status here is then of tag 0, but we have overwritten our tag value here with 1 already in the meantime, and then this interrupt handler errors out here directly and doesn't continue because the tag, the status, asynchronous status tag is 0, our internal stored tag is 1, that certainly doesn't match, so we get here tag mismatch got 0, expected 1. So yeah, I'm not yet sure, I wasted already enough time today with this, much more than I should as usual. This is why any subscribing, liking, Patreon, highly appreciated if because yeah, this is really taking so much time. So maybe we should just we have already arrays here for all those queues here for arrays in the size of regions. And maybe we should just make here some int tag array. The problem is that, is the tag in here? I think not. So the thing is that the tag is not in the structure as you see. You don't see here the tag, and the tag is in the PS3 disk generic helper structure. So we could remove it from there and move it in here, and then we have an array of tags, and then we need to iterate all of those. That is probably the most plausible and logical change here. But there you see, this is what, why do I say this? So this, I hope these videos are also interesting for other people from SGI or just generic AMD Ryzen. So much to all this Linux kernel refactoring and Foronix people who say, yay, the Linux kernel people have changed some new multi-queue stuff was merged, like, yeah, but thank you very much for causing so much extra work, because now the good old vintage stuff gets broken and bitrotten. This, by the way, when you see bitrotten, this is what the term bitrotten means. That means it was working at one point, and then people changed it and changed it and changed it, and APIs and just find and replace stuff, and then it works for something but not for some more demanding use case or for some out of kernel tree stuff. And yeah, so we need to continue with this, we need to continue with the cursors, we need to continue with RSX acceleration and 3D, and so much to do. YouTube channel's growing slightly slower than I hoped. I would have hoped by now we have 10,000 subscribers. But anyway, thank you for all of those who have already subscribed. Yeah, welcome, Dave. And this is also language to me, but alien language to me, but GlutP3 is getting some love. Yeah, welcome everyone. Thanks for watching. Hope you learned something. I also document this. It makes no sense that I sit here in some basement, which, by the way, is not a basement. sit here in the office during the weekend and do all this fun stuff. And if I would just present it to you like fully working, then you learn something. You learn nothing. I think you learn at least a little bit when you see all these small steps here. So many keyboards here. all those small steps in between, I hope you learn more. You can probably reuse this knowledge. Even I said it already, you can mostly apply this to other VMware, QEMU, VirtualBox, other PC emulator, virtualization, goodness, you name it. Yeah, this is probably all what we found out and we're looking at today. With this, it's probably time to call it a day here. Yeah, also leave me in the comments below. Someone said in the comments who may have had some knowledge, I was hoping I can disable HDMI here, some set HDMI mode for disable HTTP. Someone in the comments just today said this does not work on retail modules. Also, this is not fully reverse engineered because they do not write here the payload. So you see that often this is some structure, there's some syscon request packet here for get HTTP key here, and here is no documentation whatsoever the API parameters should look for set HDMI mode. So I would try to bitbang here some stuff, but this is also in the AV manager, which is another process there on the hypervisor. So maybe this is not as important, not sure if those people are right. If you have inside knowledge there, let me know. Also, I like to collect outstanding stuff, like, yeah, the Sony Vaio P is in its box. But when people ask me why do I have the Sony Vaio P when modern GD Pocket stuff there is more performant, of course it's also nice to collect some outstanding stuff like the Sony Vaio P or the SGI Octane. With that being said, let me know if I should spend more of our hard-earned YouTube coins here and get a debug P3. There are those debug P3s that were used for software developments that have some more features, but they are not cheap. If you sometimes find them, I should maybe not have mentioned this right now, because right now there is one on eBay for actually too much money than I would normally want to spend. But those of you who are close to this matter probably knew this already. If you want to donate to me that I get a debug P3 for maybe more fun, because they have a second HDMI port, they have a second Ethernet port, and they have twice the memory. So if you want to Patreon donate or PayPal donate or Super Chat donate, or just tell your friends and family to subscribe. reference tool, actually, I think the maybe the, so actually those the eBay listings are confusing, but I meant a reference tool. Those have two HDMI ports, so we would have dual head, we would have a second Ethernet port, and we would have twice the memory. For me, the most amazing actually would be the twice as much memory, because the 256 memory are a little bit limiting for with 512 megabyte memory, like system memory, this fancy high performance RAM bus memory. But yeah, it's so expensive. Anyway, and thanks for all the sharing and posting, that is amazing. Again, I said this is the low-hanging fruit, and you see certainly it is visible that this was totally low-hanging. I should have done this last winter, but I knew the Linux kernel broke this multi-queue block stuff for me, and this is why I was actually always, when they break something for me, then I'm always like, here, like, I better do something else first, because I knew I will spend a day or two on this bloody. And you see, if you do not know all those APIs and not the hypervisor details, of course the people who have reverse engineered this know all the details by heart, but I have not done this. I'm only continuing here other people reverse engineering efforts, and then you are the first to rediscover all the details, interrupt handling, this text, how does it work in the kernel. And yeah, also I need slightly better infrastructure, so maybe I will probably first continue the cursor stuff before I try to get 5.1 and 5.2 working. So there you, they have the Linux kernel, have people have broken even more, whatever they broke, they have no idea. That could be anything from it's just getting too large, it's just doing some power PC Mac or P series, IBM P series power stuff, memory management unit, or whatever fancy nonsense, or the kernel is just getting too large, or some I get zero. Actually, there is some low-level debugging, but also this also looks broken, so there is some low-level early printk debugging using the Ethernet. This is why I theoretically have here somewhere a UDP TCP dump with UDP on some port, whatever. Actually, I have this, so xrunder. This is also not here. So here's, I have actually some TCP dump, E0, UDP port, 18194-VV-X running, but nothing came out there. So there might so much to maybe this early printk debugging is also broken in the special just for this Gear Lake Ethernet stuff. So yeah, but whatever. I usually try to do stuff where I see some progress, so I will most likely, but not the next days, maybe in a week or two, continue with the cursor to have that in the X driver before I even continue with finding out whatever else was broken in 5.1 and 5.2. Again, let me know if I should get a reference tool debug thing with twice the memory just for the fun of it. And yeah, I'm not sure, maybe I'm the nearly first of kind of first, or at least first documented to have this at least running. This is in a way amazing. And fun fact I have done, when I've done some office administration stuff, I've actually already used VNC server to some Windows accounting stuff earlier this winter, so you could really use this for some daily use. Of course the memory is a little bit limiting, but yeah, theoretically we could also do all this kind of homebrew with Super NES and whatnot, emulation and whatnot. But yeah, memory also, yeah, then graphic acceleration. So I hope that is enough for today. Slightly too long already anyway. And let's read the comments and see if we got here any interesting comments. What am I only speaking of dual heads, this is also should actually run here my dual head nicer for better YouTube comment readout. I think I read most comments already, though. Other places bring more subscribers. Yeah, so the problem with subscribers, of course, I saw already we have already hundreds of people unsubscribed. Maybe they were all P3, so maybe we lost in 6 months 100, 200 people just for not doing P3. But on the other hand, I want to have a universal education. And this is why I also found it not only fun for me, but fun and education for you to do vintage stuff that as fast as the RSX is crashing and causing some hypervisor exception, the nicer it is to do vintage stuff on the DOS side and bare metal low level. And also I think or hope that is nice to share here. Anyway, if you feel like donating, also by the way, if you have a reference tool PS3 and don't use it, you can also donate this, otherwise I need to. Anyway, I would also, the problem is there are also the super huge, like nearly 19 inch rack mount or kind of sorta PS3s from very early tool reference development, just that I'm not sure if I can really run other OS on them. This is why I'm slightly hesitating. Also, they are even more expensive, so those you can easily spend 600 euro or dollar, which is slightly excessive. The non 19 inch or whatever, at least it looks like 19 inch regular, this form factor are slightly cheaper, like 300, still quite a lot. And yeah, let's see, are we able to use other OS plus plus? So you could have installed this already. So in an earlier state of mind, 2D acceleration was kind of usable, but the devil is in the details. So the problem is also that although I had this one state running relatively well, right now I'm not even sure if I can start the X server. I tried this earlier. The problem was also stability. So I had this, you've seen this earlier videos, not only so T2 acceleration was mostly working aside some graphic corruption, and we also had X-Video acceleration running to some degree, but not so many people reached out to me. This is why also not only did I knew the Linux kernel was broken in new versions because upstream changes, there were some graphic artifacts and graphic exceptions, and this is why I first wanted to build the channel, because all this time, as I document here, all this time takes so long that I wanted a little bit income, like in the form of $3 a day. Yeah, this is why you should share, like, and subscribe. And if you are into P3, do not unsubscribe immediately again, because you see how much time all this takes. And this is even the whole half of the day spent here on stuff that I did not even want to spend, like pure non-RSX, just pure Linux kernel debugging nonsense. That, yeah. Anyway, I think there are these homebrew libraries. I think we could potentially share some code knowledge with them, need to analyze them more. But first, next we will get this cursor stuff running. Also, it was more stable. So there's something like this Nuevo, pronunciations. This developer contributed some changes, and somehow some of them made something slightly more unstable. So before this, this code is by the way out there, right? So if you want to run this, it's on GitHub. And just that my old state was, old state meaning old X server and stuff, was slightly more stable. And anyway, there you see easily a day or two spent without much progress. This is why you should share, like, and subscribe. And that's now the last sentence for today. I hope you learned something and more amazing stuff to come. And yeah, amazing that you are also all still here and waiting for this. And you see, it's not forgotten, just that mostly, but that's the same again, I'm repeating myself, it's the same for the SGOctane, also only halfway motivated because so much upstream changes and breakage. With that, it's time to shut down here, also wrong keyboard, so shut down. And don't forget to share, like, and subscribe. And I hope to see you soon, also not an SZ, but dash also. Then we have Unicode, so this will most likely error out because of Unicode leverage. Anyway. Yep, and if you have inside knowledge, leave me in the comments below or message me privately if you have any reverse engineering inside knowledge. And yeah, thanks for waiting. Also, I've seen hundreds of people unsubscribe. Not sure if all of them are PS3 fans, but maybe many of them are. And yeah, maybe I try HDCP. Maybe I get a reference tool thing. If you want to donate for me getting a reference, it was, of course, this was this nice little cherry picking kind of stuff and birthday kind of surprises that would motivate me with a twice as much memory and dual HDMI and this kind of fun stuff is always this kind of stuff that motivates hackers and programmers and coders like one to play even more with this kind of fun stuff. So yeah. Anyway, or also, by the way, if you have this kind of reference tool P3 and have experience with this, let me know. And otherwise, leave me in the comments if I should get one, and super chat donations, Patreon, all this kind of fun stuff. Highly appreciated, because no kidding, we are still at streets. It's depressive. I only mentioned this that you see that we are not getting rich here with this YouTube with 3,000 subscribers. Oh, do we have even 3,000? I constantly forget. Let's see what we even have here. So I only mentioned this that you see from a couple of PS3 videos we are not getting millionaire here. Also not other SGA Octane people already accused us of only doing these videos to get here for the money. Yeah, $3 a day. Yeah, 3,243, amazing stuff. Highly appreciated. And yeah, revenue, although it's 27% up, which is amazing. So many political channels demotivized that that this is only up because some political channels get nothing and we get 27% more, which is maybe amazing, maybe not. But also, fun fact, for Christmas we were already higher, so of course it's highly fluctuating. For Christmas we were at $3.50 and now we were at $2.50 and this kind of fun stuff. But anyway, not complaining, only sharing this here. Do we have this even on stream? Only because people sometimes say I'm only doing this stuff for the monies here, for the monies. I would actually write some scanner driver now, and because this brings more than $3 a day, which, by the way, fun fact, left and right, the whole office surrounded with scanners, not joking. And yeah, not doing this for the money in that sort of way, but for the YouTube education and fan base growing and making this stuff working again. And yeah, amazing stuff. Now I need to go home because I should cook again. Oh, by the way, we still have some hydration stuff. As long as this stream is running, 4% frame drop, that is ridiculous. And yeah, hydration. Some good German lemonade stuff here. Only the finest, not paid advertisement, so if you work in such a lemonade company, you can contact us, though. Then we also show the logo. Maybe, allegedly, supposedly, maybe. And yeah, but it's time to say goodbye and see.